All right, good evening, good day. This is the African Crypto Warlord. We're going to quickly have a recap for the XRP USDT chart off of the last 3-day analysis that I posted. I need to put it on the 24-hour. What can we see? Off of one of the thumbnails, you would see pain or gain was written here. As you can see, it was pain. Now, what are we looking for? We're looking for any closes below 50 cents 23 for continuation to the downside, right? We've already had the first week in. Why is it going down? It's generally pushing for the new weekly mean that's been printed here, and when we drop in, we've got a new monthly mean, as it's the 1st of April. So there's a new monthly mean here at about 49 cents, which will be a target within the month, right? Given that this has been untouched, I would suggest that a monthly mean to be untouched, highly unlikely. So we know that this target, I would say, is about 80% in the books somewhere down here. Now you get the continuation drive out of here if you start closing below this Laplace level. What we'll monitor is you'll see that these become levels. So these are ranges. It gets hit into a range and then it reverses out of the range. If it keeps on closing on this side of the blue band, it has a very high chance of mean reverting to the downside, and generally this becomes a new range down to 43.74 cents, as you can see, and that's a perfect now crossing through on our Laplace distribution bell curve, right? There's another downside target here that's also technically, statistically, and probabilistic in the area, in the region, and they're both getting timed. This is the mean it needs to keep above, so just call it 42 cents for longer term mean reversion. As we stated, some silly pattern like a head and shoulders. Obviously this is a little bit of a front run up. That's on the 24-hour. What I will do here is I'll just show you the 1 minute, so by the time we get back here we can see what's happening. This is the same play. It's come, this is the range, it breaks the range, it wants to push for blue. As you can see, it never got the blue, so now this is its new range under negative skew. So these regions are more than likely to be shorted. You look for a lot of bullish action if we start closing about 51.22 to mean revert back up to 51.69. This is a pivot that we set for the 12-hour. We'll look for continuation down. I'll link the analysis up here in the top right, and these are panic where retail sellers are going to be panicking, and as you can see, they've been smoked quite a bit, and there is a region for them obviously to reclaim their gains if they've held on to their losses. Okay, and that can be flummoxed with also, again, if it does get up to this region, there's a target that stops it here. Now, these are the previous two targets that we know. If it can reclaim this region, we know that this is a long-term pivot. I don't know if you guys can hear that sound. It's a bush, baby. A night egg. Okay, so that's just on the 1 minute for the intraday, homies. And let me start here. Up here is our new daily, well, it's not new, it's pretty much 22 hours old, is the daily mean that has not been touched. So technically we have a new monthly mean that hasn't been touched, and we have a new daily mean that hasn't been touched. So it's a coin flip on which side it's going to go. Technically it will touch here in the month, and this is an untouched monthly mean. Now I'm going to do a quick breakdown just to show you guys a trend. Mean reversion to the upside has had its outlier event coming into an outlier event. What stopped the outlier event is this mean, alright, which is currently why there's an outlier event there. There is mean reversion play. The general observation here is you close above 51.46 for continuation to the upside. Open and close two candles. This becomes a viable target again with a mean reversion play. Mean reversion play. Generally, the red flashes on expansion to the upside. Let me make this quick. 7-day. 7-day was a good one here. So as you can see, this will be our new range. 51 to 45. You break below there, there's a mean reversion play. But we'll just leave this now in the analysis. This is the range. It's about a 10% range to the downside. Okay. What stopped this? What made this candle go like this and return it back into the cone? When trading view loads, is our reverse wave trend here. That is the outlier event. All right, to look for continuation, you pretty much need the next candle to close in here and then above here, and that'll push this very, very close to the outlier event. We do have upside here. There are some red flashes on. technically it's still expanding to the upside. What we'll look for on the next 7-day print, if I can do this right, which would be in 2 days' time. Sorry, in 2 days' time, what I'll be looking for is when it prints, does this lose its trend? And if it does, I know it's mean reverting back down to 44.68 for the long term. All right, 7 days done. 5 day. 5 day needs to hold above reverse wave trend. That's currently what's holding up this price action here. That's stuck between the 14-day and the 7-day. We have a 5-day, which is this reverse wave trend over here, which is at about 51 cents. Start closing above there for continuation up. First side that stops it is 51.33 cents. Now we're going to pop it onto the daily. Onto the daily, what can we see? We can see that we came in all the way down here from the outlier event. This is our distribution cone. Broke through the range, hit this range, accumulated above the bullish breakout range. Boom. Into the random distribution level up here. Perfectly to the T, scalped it down. I scalped out somewhere here. Scalps it down. And you look for continuation drive if you start closing candles below 52.45 to the downside. And your general target is back down to this pink line that we see here, and that's currently at 48, just call it 44 cents for next week, for tomorrow. Okay, and we'll just put the VREs on, and we can see that that matches up here. And as you start to zoom in, we'll see that this daily means that is actually somewhere up in this region. Let me just remember, what's this? 52.40. Okay, and here, VRE, where's that? 5400 hasn't been touched, so it's 5400. 5400 is pretty much just to the top side here. We can catch that later. All right, so there's mean reversion play on the 12-hour to the upside, and the general idea being is if it holds above this red line, it's wanting to pretty much mean revert back to its target here at 52.37. It did come down, seeing as a lot of things in XRP on the lower 10 time frames have been front run. Maybe this is a little bit of a front run. I'm not too sure yet, but my general observation where I'd be safe is when it comes and touches the orange band. Whilst it's going down, touches it, and I see if the volatility flips. Currently, it's contracting, was positively correlated, which should technically keep this bullish signature from breaking out. There is an outlier event here, so maybe on Sunday there will be a confirmation. What is trying to turn it around is the 6-hour, but the 6-hour doesn't have the legs as of yet to break it through, as there is negative drift in the book. Even though there's a perfect mean reversion here, and these guys are starting to reverse around, when I know this gives up the chase of pushing it down is when I see this blue flash a little bit, and this doesn't move, I see the blue flash switch off, then I know, okay, just awkward size in the candles, they may not be on the wrong side of anything, and follow mean reversion through. So there's a few signatures. Now, on the 3-hour, what can we see? We can see that there is a drive for bullish div. A drive for bullish play coming through. What's going to stop it? Any closes below 51 cents, which we've already demarcated earlier on higher term timeframes, actually. So any closes below 51 cents, you're going to look for mean reversion back down to here at 47.95, which is about the general area that we're looking at for the higher term timeframe, which we'll wait for a touch to come in. Anyway, if it does start closing above 51 cents, the 3-hour does have the opportunity to start playing around in these wicks over here, and then we'll look for a new set of games. But currently, the safest target for the next 30 days is 48.99. All right. What can you see here? We can see 90-minute battling it out on a reverse wave trend. Currently, it's failing under negative drift. So we'll go see if there's anything I can mess that up. There is a bull div signature, so we'll look for something like a 15-minute to kick it up. 45-minute having a kick. That's looking all right. So there might be a little bit of a bullish push. I would say 52.62 is two means that have crossed here. But it will only really get that continuation if it gets above 51.20 and keeps its steam. And as you can see, there's a whole bunch of levels in between here that can start cutting its steam. But if it can keep its steam for long enough, this becomes a quick run back up to the daily. And then we'll have to relook at this data if that's where it is tomorrow. That could mess with a lot of the higher term time frames that we've been observing. Contraction was positively correlated, still sort of keeping it down. Seems like there are some bullish people in XRP buying pretty much every little dip here. All right. What can we see? Denied a mean reversion on 5 minutes. Getting played around here. Alright. That's alright. Mean reversion. It has the opportunity to get to 51.10. 51.10. Currently, there's mean reversion back down to the downside. We want to put on some VREs. This will be the current range. 50.36. Break out a little bit more down. And 51.36. So pretty much 100. Pretty much a 1 cent move to tag either the untouched yellow, which printed today, and the untouched monthly. Alright, so sure, this is going to be a lot of signal pressing. Good thing we got the 1 minute Laplace distribution cone to set. Okay, if it does break out here, we know that people will be panic selling into 50 cents 23. There is negative skew, so let's see if it can piled above this blue range. I look for pink range, and yeah, we can see that if it gets up into this pink range, there is a target over here at 51.36, which did pop up. That will reflect in the book in about 5-7 minutes for me, so that the video won't be uploaded in time, unfortunately. But these targets do come back into play. Hard side scalps to the top here if it does get there. And if you found this information helpful, please do like and subscribe. As I say, a little bit sketchy to be trading it, but I expect 48.96 within the month. And sure, the new daily mean, we need to control Z, the new daily mean will print somewhere halfway in this region tomorrow, so that will be the target that, if you guys observe here, will pop up. Alright, so I'm expecting maybe a daily mean in this region. If it doesn't dump, if it gets to this before close in the next 4 hours, and I expect the daily mean to pretty much be in line with this current price structure. But if we hold above in this red range that we demarcated until daily close, or even if we pump back up here, I will suggest that the daily mean will be printing more than likely in between these two bands, or here if it gets down to here. So I know that these targets are in play, as this is high term. These are 12 hours, and this was like a 3-day continuation. So we know that if we're below here, we look for 3-day continuation down. If we know that we're above here, we look for 12-hour continuation up. If you find this information helpful, please do like and subscribe. Trade safely, and I'll be looking for 48.97 within the month. And if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I'll know if I'm wrong if we start closing above here for many, many days. But for now, I know that this is my target. If you found this information helpful, please do like and subscribe. African Crypto Warlord out. I'll leave you with this coin. Here, here, and bullish continuation in 52.57. Hope that was helpful. Ciao.